Hello everyone and welcome to another video. As you can see, the colors of my game are completely different from what they usually are. This is not done with video effects, but rather with a different color palette in the game. Before we can talk about how to do that, we need to talk about how the color palettes actually work. First though, I want to give a quick heads up that I livestream on Twitch on every Sunday and every Wednesday at 8 PM CET. People fairly often come into my Twitch chat saying they had no idea that I streamed on Twitch, so I thought I'd tell you at the start of a video for once. This is the standard color palette, which gives you 32 different colors to choose from when coloring a ride or a scenery item. This is something that we all know, but what you might not know is that everything in the game is colored using these 32 colors. Well, the game does use a few more shades of every color, of course, but the point is that the colors in this palette and the colors of things that are not colorable are connected. You can actually see this when you change the color of the water. This is a park with a standard watercolor and some rides that are painted in various shades of blue. Now watch what happens when I change the watercolor to acid green. The color of the water changes, obviously, but some of the colors on the right have also changed. What's going on here? Well, the color of the water is based on two of the 32 colors in this palette. This one is called dark water and the one to the right of it is called light water. When you change the color of the water, the game actually replaces these two colors with different colors, and since the water depends on those two colors, it also changes to the new colors that you've selected. Here you can see the palette for every one of the four standard watercolors that are in the vanilla game. 30 of the colors are the same every time, but the colors called light and dark water are different, and as a result, the water is also a different color. So if you want to make your coaster so bright acid green that it hurts your eyes, you now know how. We still have to answer the question of how I got my game to look like this. Well, just like you can make custom objects, you can also make custom color palettes where you can change every color. The one that I'm using right now looks like this, for example. I did not make this myself, by the way. I got it with some park I downloaded a long time ago. If you want to learn how to make your own custom color palette, I've linked Dirklink's guide to it in the description. Before we end the video, I want to show off a few more custom palettes that I have acquired over the years. This one is called Palette of the Dead. It's completely normal, except that the guests now have a grey skin color, making them look dead. Notice that since the bricks in the entrance and exit buildings use the same color as the skin of the guests, they are also grey now. This one is called Fantasy Yellow Grass, which makes your grass yellow and also changes some other colors. It's not my favorite look, but it can look good in parks that are built specifically for it. The last one is one that makes everything the worst color in the game, Salmon Pink. This one was made for me by a Twitch viewer and I absolutely hate it, but it does nicely show off what you can do with custom palettes. And that was it for this colorful video. I hope you learned something new and maybe are inspired to now make your own custom color palette. If you liked this video, consider giving it a like or leave a comment. You can also subscribe or follow me on Twitch. Thank you all for watching and I will see you in the next video.